Oh, you are already there. Sorry for wasting your time, and I'm wasting my time. And wasting time is a sin in Calvinism. But what does Calvinism have to do with Lean Thinking and Six Sigma? It was a trigger. This video is about the historical roots and the development of Lean Thinking and Six Sigma. The story begins in the 16th century with the Swiss-French theologian Jean Calvin. He was convinced that the fate of every human being is predestined by God, even before his birth, to belong either to the chosen ones or to the damned. The chosen ones receive salvation, the others the wrath of God for their sins. At that time, the individual economic success was interpreted as a visible sign of God's election. However, since no one could know whether he or she was chosen by God or condemned, and because people wanted to be publicly perceived as chosen, the diligence at work became a Calvinist principle. The followers of the doctrine worked very hard to earn money and thus to improve their public image. Not only the waste of time, but also every kind of luxury was considered a sin. Economic success on the one hand and the ban on luxury on the other led to a surplus of money. This money was reinvested in technologies, machines, and methods, which made the work more efficient, led to higher volumes, and thus further increased the economic success. The diligence, in Latin industria, thus became a trigger of industrialization. Machine power, the standardization of parts, and the division of labor belong to the resources and methods for more efficiency. The disassembly lines in the slaughterhouses of Cincinnati and Chicago were the model for the assembly lines in automobile production, initially at Ford and Citroën. Frederick Winslow Taylor's scientific management had a strong impact on the division and sequencing of the work into only a few specialized operations for each worker, which had to be exactly repeated throughout the entire shift. According to Taylor, the work processes have to be subdivided to such an extent that even a trained monkey can perform them. Workers no longer had an overview of the subdivided process, no say, and no responsibility for the status of the work results. This had a negative effect on the quality of the final product. For this reason, Henry Ford introduced a quality control system in which finished products were inspected and the defective products were sorted out and repaired. The movie Modern Times, by and with Charlie Chaplin, caricatures the consequences of the assembly line on the workers. Quality control prevents the customer from receiving a defective product, but the reactive repair of a finished product is expensive. Walter Schuert recognized this, developed the control chart, and became a pioneer of statistical process control. The control charts, installed at significant steps along the process chain, indicate the extent of conformity or deviation of the process from its specifications. Schuert showed that reducing the variation of the process proactively led to an improvement of its outputs, and he implicitly founded the central principle of Six Sigma, Y is a function of X, with the idea to control the relationship between the influences in the process and the properties of the output. William Deming expanded the view from the quality defects of the products to the processes in which the defects were caused, and from value-adding processes to support processes. He emphasized the role of management and formulated its tasks for the quality management. Together with Karu Ishikawa, he was convinced that employees were the experts of their work and therefore had to be involved in the analysis and improvement of the respective processes. Now the entire company became the focus of improvements. Karu Ishikawa emphasized the importance of internal customer, developed the Fishbone cause and effect diagram, which is an important tool of the seven tools of quality. And he developed the idea of quality circle, in which employees systematically eliminate waste and contribute to the continuous improvement of the processes according to the PDCA cycle. The PDCA cycle was developed by Deming and Schuert, and the definition of waste was introduced by Taishi Ono. The PDCA cycle is the predecessor of the DMEC cycle of Six Sigma, and the additional consideration of waste justifies the concept of Lean Six Sigma today. Due to his expansions of Deming's concepts, Ishikawa is considered the founder of company-wide quality control, the Japanese way of quality management. In the United States, Armand Feigenbaum developed, with his concept of total quality control, a similar management system for the development, maintenance, and improvement of quality. In TQC, each employee of a company is basically responsible for the quality of his or her work. This responsibility is regularly concretized in the quality-relevant objectives of the corporate units. Associated data are collected and checked in order to counteract deviations. The source for the objectives are customer satisfaction and the company's quality costs. In the following years, the American approach of TQC and the Japanese CWQC merged into the concept of total quality management, which additionally considers the relevant environment of the company. Indicators for business excellence were developed and awards were given to the most competitive companies, like the Deming Prize in Japan, the EFQM Award in Europe, and the Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Award in the United States. The Toyota Production System, developed by Toyota, Toyota and Ono, is currently considered the best practice of a total quality management. Masaaki Ima summarized the core of Japanese TQM in his book Kaizen for a Change for the Best. Kaizen became very popular in Europe and the United States as the basis of continuous improvement processes and the core of lean ideas. The term lean encompasses various business areas: lean management, lean production, lean administration, but also, for example, lean development and lean construction are commonly referred to as lean thinking. And lean thinking has recently replaced the term TQM. Parallel to Masaaki Imai's Kaizen, William Smith developed Six Sigma at Motorola. The trigger was a specific quality problem in Motorola's semiconductor division, and one customer required a performance level of Six Sigma. This requirement is the origin of the developed method to achieve this performance level. For many companies, General Electric is the role model for the successful implementation of Six Sigma. In summary, it can be said that faith in God stimulated productivity, and increased productivity required a management of quality. There are many different opinions on this topic, and my brief overview thus also reflects my personal point of view. Nevertheless, it might help you to understand why both approaches are important today, why they have become necessary, and what their purposes are.